Guys, every 60 seconds in Africa, a minute passes.
Today, we wanted to talk to you guys about an empire which was located in the west of Africa. At the time, it was historically known as Manden Kuru Faba, and it existed from somewhere around 1235 up until about 1670.
This great empire, which was founded by Sundiata Keita after his victory over the kingdom of Soso, was famous for its wealth and prosperity. Sundiata's centralized government, his diplomacy, and his well-trained military contributed greatly to the expansion of the Mali Empire, and it opened up the gateway and paved the path to a great flourishing of the empire.
One of the main things that gained the Mali Empire its fame was its wealth and prosperity of its rulers. One such ruler was Mansa Musa, probably the only guy you've heard of from this empire, and definitely its most famous. Mansa Musa was the 10th ruler of the Mali Empire, and was also Musa Keita's nephew. The term Mansa refers to a ruler, king, or emperor. Interestingly, Mansa Musa has been described as the wealthiest individual of the Middle Ages, and maybe even in human history. Fun fact, when Europeans first heard about Mansa Musa and his wealth, they drew him on the maps as white, despite knowing that the people of his land were black. They did this because they thought only a white man could be so rich. This only changed when European diplomats, aka pirates, went over and saw him in the flesh.
The reign of Mansa Musa saw the empire reach new heights in terms of territory controlled, cultural fluorescence, and the staggering wealth brought from Mali's control of regional trade routes. This made the Mali Empire one of the most powerful and wealthy empires of all time.
Please, just stop. In the Mali Empire, the main languages spoken were the Manding languages. Mansa Musa and other emperors spoke Arabic as well. The Manding languages had a script which had been inspired by Arabic and Latin letters. One such language that still lives today is Mandinka, which is often spoken in modern-day Senegal. Here are a few phrases translated from Mandinka into English. Fu Watidu, good morning. Etin Yang, good evening. Suto Yediya, how are you? Kori Tanante, how is it? Mbe Yelasayu, what's your name?
Here's a fun fact for you before we continue. Mansa Musa built a mosque every time he stopped on the way to Hajj. Hajj being the pilgrimage in Islam where Muslims go to Mecca in Saudi Arabia and do several holy rituals, including circulating a black cube-shaped building called the Kaaba 7 times. Let's talk about the social structure of the Mali Empire. At the top is obviously the Mansa, the emperor of the empire. Next in line we have the priests, who were respected in the community. After this we have the griot. These people are historians and storytellers. And at the very bottom of the social pyramid are the slaves. While everyone in the empire had a certain extent of freedom, slaves had the least of it. By far. Mali slaves were usually women, and they were harshly abused, both mentally and physically.
Alright, now let's talk about the culture in the Mali Empire. This place was pretty rich in culture, if you ask me. Their arty interests included textiles, wood carving, jewellery, music, storytelling, and architecture. Let's briefly talk about each of those. The textiles there were typically colourful and patterned. Some were made by beating designs cut onto stamps onto a piece of cloth. The wooden sculptures made by the people were very impressive, but gender was very important to them, so certain body parts were greatly exaggerated and increased in size, if you get what I mean. They also made practical items for everyday use, such as intricately detailed doors. Jewelry was very important to both the women and the men. Gold was preferred among the people of Mali. The wealthy of the women would wear huge 14-carat gold earrings that were so heavy that the top of each earring was bound with red wool or silk to protect the ear.
Thank you everyone so much for watching today's video. We hope you enjoyed. Please make sure to subscribe and hit that like button.